spoons. Hoping to find we're two of a kind. Make it a go, make it grow together.
About spending my first Christmas with my dad.
Well, you know, I think your father's very excited about spending his first Christmas with you, too.
Really? Mm-hmm. What makes you say that?
Oh, just a feeling. Oh, I almost forgot. This came for you.
Hey, it's a Christmas card from Grandfather. From the desk of E.W. Stratton II. Richard, kindest regards of the season. Grandfather.
And people say he never gets into the Christmas spirit.
Well, at least he typed it in red ink.
Right.
And look, a $20 bill.
Yeah. Oh, and he also sent this basket.
Look at this. Fruit, cheese, candied oysters.
Well, it's an improvement. Last year it was chocolate-covered snails.
Well. Kid, I sure wish you could spend Christmas with us.
Oh, me too. But my family is expecting me back in Columbus.
I was hoping you could see my dad's face when he opens up the present I'm giving him. It's the world's greatest pen. It's got a calculator in it, an alarm, a flashlight, a radio, a watch, and a built-in computer game.
Yeah, but does it write?
I forgot to check.
I'm sure it does.
Hi! Merry Christmas.
Hello, mister. I just moved into the neighborhood, and I was wondering if you had any odd jobs for me to do. I need to earn a dollar to buy my mom a Christmas present.
Well, come in. Come in. It's cold out there.
You're not just whistling Dixies. Wow. What a tree. Is this the White House?
No, I live here. Now, you said you want the job.
Forget that. How about adopting me?
Why don't you come by the fire and get warm?
So, what's your name?
Joey Thompson.
I'm Ricky Stratton, and this is Kate Summers.
Nice to meet you.
My pleasure.
Joey, would you like a cookie? Look at him, Kate. He's starving.
Yeah.
He's got holes in his jacket.
Would you like some hot cocoa?
Wow, I'd love some.
Joey, I really don't think there's any jobs around here for you to do.
Please, I need to earn a dollar. I'll do anything, Mr. Stratton. I'm a hard worker. I may be small, but I'm wiry.
Joey, please don't call me mister. Although to you, I may seem like an awesome giant. I'm actually only 12 years old.
Really? I guess you're 10, you know, 11 tops.
Second thought, call me mister.
Look, I'll do any job, no matter how awful it is. However, when I get paid, I prefer cash.
You know, there is something you could do for me. I could use a good ornament hanger.
I'm your man. I'm good at that.
Here you go. Hang that on the tree for me. bare spot there, and you covered it all up.
I told you I'm good.
Here's your hot cocoa. Careful.
What else do you want me to do, mister?
Mister? Leave it alone, Kate. That's all there is to do, Joey.
That's it? Oh, heck. I need to earn a dollar bad.
You did. Plus a $19 tip. Now you go buy your mom something nice for Christmas.
Okay. Hey, I bet with this much, I could buy our mink coat or something.
Joey, would you like a ride home? It's awfully cold outside.
No, thanks. I don't live far. Bye. Merry Christmas.
Bye. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. That was terrific. Where did you get all that Christmas spirit?
Simple, Kate. I just thought of what Derek would have done in this situation, and I did the opposite.
Interesting approach.
I just hope my dad's in the Christmas spirit as much as I am.
Good King Wenceslas looked out on the feast of Stephen.
Hey, Dad, how do you like the Christmas tree?
Oh, Christmas tree, how lovely are thy branches.
Edward, I took all your decorations.
I know, Kate, and you've decked the halls with boughs of holly. I feel pretty good.
No kidding.
Yeah, this time of year, my blood's not only red, it's red and green. Thank you. Look at this great tree. Look at these great decorations. Look at this great food. Now, see the effect Christmas has on people. Even my father sent us a basket of goodies. Candied oysters? Now, that's a shame. It's bad enough to be born an oyster, but to end up candied.
Edward?
Look at this man. Look at him.
Who, me?
Yes, you. Len, come on. You're so unbending, so stiff. Loosen up, guy. Come on, little Christmas spirit.
I got the world on a string, sitting on a rainbow.
Len, buddy, see, that's not a Christmas song.
See what happens when I try to loosen up?
Well, gang, I've got to be going.
No, no, Kate, you can't leave yet. We haven't had the ceremonial lighting of the Christmas tree. Come on, Len, you get on the drums. Kate, get the lights. And let's see now, who's the youngest blonde kid in this house?
I am!
Who is?
I am!
Oh, you are, okay. You take a hold of the extension cord of honor. Leonard, if you please. The world has waited long enough. Let Christmas begin.
Merry Christmas, Leonard.
Merry Christmas,
oh,
Kate.
And thank you for that fruitcake you gave me.
Thanks for the fruitcake you gave me.
Merry Christmas, Ricky.
Merry Christmas, Kate. Did you remember to pack my present?
I sure did.
Hope you like it. I made it myself in wood shop. If you're not sure what it is when you open it, just call me.
You call me when you arrive, okay?
I will.
Oops. Mistletoe. Rick's first Christmas here is going to be the greatest one ever. Oops. Mistletoe. I got him something he has been dying for. A computerized dune buggy. It's got 5 speeds. It's real fast. It's beautifully built. I can't wait. I mean, I can't wait to see his face when he opens it up. Yeah. You know something, Kate? I'm really gonna miss you.
Oh.
Your present.
And yours.
Oops. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Okay, what do you say, Len?
Right. Let's get those toys down to the children's hospital. I've got a long drive to Philly tonight.
Right.
Thank you. Have a happy Christmas, Rick.
Thanks, Len.
Okay, Len, let's fire up the old spirit of St. Nicholas and make some kids happy. We'll see you in a couple hours, son.
Okay, Dad. Drive carefully.
Okay. You ready, Len?
As I'll ever be.
Here we go.
Ta-da!
Where'd you get all this stuff? We don't take handouts, son.
This is not a handout. I met this really rich guy in this big house. And I asked him for a job, and he gave it to me.
Ellen, can you believe what's happened to us in a year? Last year, we had a house, a new car. We were living the American dream.
Jack, it'll all work out. We're healthy. We're together. And it's Christmas.
And we're living in a cave.
There's some interesting things here.
We have some patties.
That's pate, Joey.
What's pate?
Goose liver.
Pass.
Just isn't fair. I had seniority. 15 years I worked for that company, and they let me go like that.
Honey, you're not alone. A lot of steel mills are closing down. Now, you'll find another job when we get to Denver.
Maybe. If we ever get enough money to fix the truck.
At least it broke down near this cozy cave.
Dad, want some candied oysters?
Pass.
I think we'd better get a move on if we're going to get to church on time.
Maybe. Yeah, that's right. Maybe we can leave the candied oysters for Santa.
Son, I don't think Santa's going to come this year.
Why not?
Well, I'm not sure Santa knows where we are.
What do you mean? I thought Santa knew everything.
Well, he does, Joey. It's just that there wasn't time to send him a change of address card.
You mean he's going to leave my gifts at our old house? We better go back.
We can't. It belongs to the bank now. Look, Joey, next year, I promise you, Santa will know exactly where we are, and we'll have the best Christmas ever.
Okay, but can we leave the candied oysters just in case he comes?
Here, Joey.
Stay here while I find a candle.
Did you remember to stomp your feet?
Right. We don't want to get our cave dirty.
We must be in the wrong cave.
No, you're not.
Who are you?
I'm Ricky Stratton, ma'am.
He's the guy in the big house.
I appreciate this, but we really don't like to take charity.
It's not charity.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Stratton.
Call me Ricky, okay?
I should call you Santa Claus, because that's who you are, as far as I'm concerned.
No, I'm not Santa Claus, and I'm glad you brought that up. Because when you told me that you guys had just moved, I figured that it'd be hard for Santa to locate you. So I sent him a telegram.
You think we'll get it in time?
Ho, ho, ho!
You never know.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Does Joey Thompson live here?
Yeah, it's me!
Ho, ho! Well, 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 Joey. You know, if I hadn't gotten that telegram, I wouldn't have known you were here. How are you, Joey?
Great, Santa. I mean, how are you?
Well, I'm a little tired. This is my busy season, you know. Plus, I got a power struggle going on. The Teamsters trying to unionize my elves. Well, you don't want to hear my troubles. Say, Joey, you think there might be something in my sack for you?
Well, I sure hope so. I have them real good. Well, except for that one day when I shaved my neighbor's dog.
Ho, ho, ho. Oh, here's one, and it says, I belong to Joey.
Wow, can I open it now?
Sure.
Wow, a dune buggy. I've always wanted one of these.
Me too.
Santa, I want to talk to you.
In just a minute. Let's see if there's something in here for Joey's dad. Ho, ho, ho.
Go on, Jack. Open it. What a wonderful pen.
Oh, ho, it's more than just a pen. Push that button.
8:32 p.m., December 24th. Merry Christmas.
This is great. It's just what I always wanted.
Me too.
Let's see if there's something for Joey's mom. Ho, ho, ho.
Just what I've always wanted.
Me too. That negligee was supposed to be for Kate. Right now she's in Columbus opening a genuine oak spice rack.
Let's face it, Santa, you blew it.
Well, Merry Christmas, everybody.
Do you have to go now, Santa?
Well, I guess I could stay a while and give Rudolph a rest. Ho, ho, ho. Think I'll have some eggnog.
Listen, who are you?
Edward Stratton III.
You know, my first instinct was to throw you out of here.
What's your second instinct?
Say thank you. You really made my son happy. I'm gonna pay you back for all this.
No, it's not necessary. It's Christmas and the spirit of Christmas.
I don't take handouts. I'll find some way to pay you back.
Well, I respect that. I'll tell you what. We'll take it out of your first week's paycheck.
My what?
Your first week's paycheck. See, I own a factory, and I can really use men like you.
Yeah?
Yeah, definitely. What do you do?
I was foreman at a steel mill.
Well, now, see, this is a coincidence, because my factory makes toys. You see the connection?
Not off the top of my head.
Yeah, well, you see, you're a foreman, and you know how to manage people. Well, let's say that you're in charge of the potato wiggler assembly line. Now, you see one of your men start to play with one of them. What do you do?
I tell him to wait until break time.
You're hired! We'll discuss the details tomorrow.
Tomorrow's Christmas.
We'll take the day off.
Is all this on the level?
You bet.
You've got a deal. Helen, this guy really is Santa Claus. I just got a job.
Isn't this great?
Sure is.
You know that pen was supposed to be for you.
You know that dune buggy was supposed to be for you. I think it worked out just right.
You know what?
What?
This is the best Christmas ever.